It's morning in the city by the bay. How you doing? I'm Mal Sharpe, your man on the street. For years, I've been walking around San Francisco, the Bay Area, and talking to folks. I think they're a pretty unique group. Intelligent, friendly, always willing to take part in something a little bit off the wall. Coming up, I'm going to tell some unsuspecting pedestrians a joke that has a totally meaningless punchline. No punchline whatsoever. Will they laugh? To help me out, I've got a couple of shills. On the left, my wife Sandra. On the right, Oakland restaurateur Gerard Noel. Here we go. Here's today's joke. A priest, a minister, and a rabbi decide to go to the Super Bowl. Now, they can't get good tickets, so they sit in the end zone behind the goalpost. In the last quarter, a guy kicks a field goal. The ball is coming right toward the three of them. Okay, they jump up. The fans are screaming. The priest crosses himself, and he says, Jesus, I want to get this ball. The minister, you know, looks at the ball, and he says, Lord, I want this one for my little kid. The rabbi is waving his arms. He's jumping up and down in the air. Suddenly, he stops. He looks right at the priest and the minister, and he says, wait a minute. Where did we park the car?
That's a good one.
Wait a minute. Where did we park the car? Where did we park the car? You know, we don't want to really use the baseball.
Okay.
We're going to hurt people. We're going to use marshmallows.
Okay.
Can you hit the marshmallow?
I think so. I've never played marshmallow baseball, but I could give it a shot.
Base is loaded, top of the ninth, the windup and the pitch. Oh, strike three, you're out of there.
Wind up the pitch. Everybody in America wants to make a fast buck. I know I do. So we did some research here at flea markets, and we found out that the biggest sellers are socks and vegetables. So we put these two items together in a vegetable and a sock. Would it sell?
Vegetable and a sock?
How much?
25 cents.
What is this here?
Vegetable and a sock.
My gracious, I never heard of such a thing in my life.
It'd be best to put all artichokes, for example, in the same color sock.
Why?
If somebody wanted artichokes, that way they'd have a pair of socks.
But the purpose is really just the sock, the vegetable in the sock. It's not the...
What are you selling, vegetables or socks?
That's the point. San Franciscans are sophisticated. 20 years ago, they experienced the summer of love. But are things the same today? Now, the people you're looking at here are all actors. We took them downtown to confront pedestrians with a roadblock of love. How would you react to this?
Give me a kiss that fill a dream on. My imagination will drive upon that kiss. Sweetheart, I ask no more than this. A kiss that fill a dream on. Give me a kiss before you leave me, and my imagination will feed my hungry heart. Leave me one thing before we part, a kiss to build a dream on.
Can I now just give you a deposit for a couple of hours, and can you just take me on a brief test drive?
Let me say this. The deposit means nothing, sir, because the fact is we sell a car here. It's all by ourselves.
Okay, look, here's the deposit.
What do you got the handcuffs on for?
Huh?
What do you got the handcuffs on for?
The handcuffs.
I was
at a correctional facility this morning. All right, so here's the down payment here on the thing. And
What's this, though?
Handcuffs.
No way.
It's just
right.
No, just
take a hike. Well, what do you got there?
I got about $900 there. Huh? And we take a test ride?
Huh? What else do you have there?
What do you mean?
Are you wanted for anything?
Oh, the handcuffs.
Yeah.
No. The handcuffs aren't any big deal.
You
I was
got
at
something
a
something under that coat?
Huh? What do you mean?
Serious? Larry!
Here's a simple street game that'll only cost you 25 cents. Take your quarter. Put it in the news rack, open it up, take your fish, put it inside, slam the door, then stand back and see what happens.
You know about the fish in there?
No, what's happening?
You don't know about that?
Oh my God. It's a fish.
You're kidding. this is a dramatic moment in American history. Geraldine Ferraro has just accepted the vice presidential nomination, the first woman to be nominated for vice president. Is this exciting?
Extremely exciting. Looking forward to an extremely successful
November. Okay, what's your favorite fish?
My favorite fish?
Yeah.
Tuna.
What is it?
Tuna.
Tuna. Okay. How you doing? Are you excited about this?
Very proud to be a woman tonight. It was a marvelous speech.
Okay, we always ask this. What's your favorite fish?
Sea bass.
Sea bass. Mine too.
I'm from Puerto Rico.
What's your favorite fish?
Fish?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
What's your favorite fish? What do you like?
I love codfish.
Codfish. Governor of Arizona, how you doing?
Look, it's a historic moment. It was a terrific speech. She's really the master of her style. It's really upbeat.
Governor of Arizona, what's your favorite fish?
Striped bass.
Striped bass. All right, you heard it from the governor. Thanks a lot.
Love it.
Where are you from?
Washington, D.C.
What is your favorite fish?
What am I supposed to say? Why are you asking that question?
What do you mean? What's your favorite?
Salmon.
Salmon, okay. What's your favorite fish?
My favorite what?
Fish.
Trout.
Trout. Thanks a lot.
Swordfish.
Swordfish. How about you?
Lobster.
Lobster is not a fish.
Yes, I know.
It's a crustacean.
Actually, I like shark.
He spoke to every issue that concerns America today.
What is your favorite fish?
Fish?
Catfish.
Catfish.
Right.
Okay, you heard it here. We have a new nominee for Vice President Geraldine Ferraro. We have a new favorite fish, catfish. And don't forget, lobster is not a fish. It's a crustacean.